Now that we understand a little about what an outlier is, let's take a look at one through an example. Here we have some income data that's spread out in a histogram to show how the values are distributed. It's apparent that most of the values representing people's income are within the 0 to 100,000 range. But there's one value, someone making $1 million, that we can see out here on the right. That might fit with what we've described as extreme or abnormal, or a great distance from most of the values in the data set. And if we think about it, one instance of a report of $1 million income compared to 40 other values that are from 0 to 100,000 is really quite abnormal. We could probably consider this an outlier. But what if that single value was only 200,000? And it looked like this. It is far to the right and seems to be extreme, but 200,000 compared to the range of 0 to 100,000 isn't quite that extreme. So is it an outlier? It actually may not matter whether or not we label a point as an outlier. What does matter is that we identify extreme data points and understand how they impact our results.